T-minus 10, go for main engine start. We are go for main engine start. T-minus 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and liftoff of the Space Shuttle Discovery with the Hubble Space Telescope.
Mission Control, Houston.
Right. I'll start with the bad news. Telescopes on Earth have bad views, cause light gets distorted by the air and we end up with images of space that we can't use. So we put a telescope up above the sky, 350 miles high, 43 feet long, 14 wide. We named it after Edwin, that's this guy.
That's a telescope they're installing.
Oh yeah.
It's in orbit, and that's why Hubble can see. It can tell telescopically how to build new galaxies. And the rate at which they recede, that's what Hubble can see.
When the pics came back, they were kind of blurred. Didn't take them long to figure out what had occurred. Turns out the main mirror wasn't shaped right, and so the Hubble couldn't focus on the starlight. So in 93 they went up in a shuttle, brought some spectacles to help out Hubble. Five spacewalks, a couple new arrays, and then they could see deep space.
Woo! I'm talking about stellar nurseries,
somewhere old galaxy.
NGC 3603,
antenna galaxies.
This looks like the eye of a cat.
That's what Hubble can see.
Hubble, you can see so far.
You can see so far.
With your Cassegrain reflector in your co-star. Cost billions to make you. But it might be worth it for the space view.
Hubble can see. Don't you think that space is enthralling? You can't ignore it, and that's what Hubble can see. It can tell telescopically how to build new galaxies, and the rate at which they recede, that's what Hubble can see.